In this video, we will learn to find the limit of tangent of x minus sine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. Let us assume L is the limit of tangent of x minus sine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. At x is equal to 0, tangent of x minus sine of x is equal to 0. The limit is indeterminate from 0 upon 0, so let us further simplify the limit to avoid this indeterminate form. We know tangent of x is equal to sine of x upon cosine of x. Here I have replaced tangent of x by sine of x upon cosine of x. Addition of the fractions in the numerator gives us L is equal to limit of sine of x minus sine of x times cosine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. Further simplification gives us L is equal to limit of sine of x minus sine of x times cosine of x upon cube of x times cosine of x as x approaches 0. Taking out common factor sine of x in the numerator gives us L is equal to limit of sine of x times 1 minus cosine of x upon cube of x times cosine of x as x approaches 0. Multiplying the numerator and the denominator of a fraction by a common factor does not change the value of the fraction. So, let us multiply the numerator and the denominator by common factor 1 plus cosine of x. 1 minus cosine of x times 1 plus cosine of x is equal to square of 1 minus square of cosine of x. So, L is equal to limit of sine of x times 1 minus square of cosine of x upon cube of x times cosine of x times 1 plus cosine of x as x approaches 0. We know 1 minus square of cosine of x is equal to square of sine of x. Here, I have applied this identity. Here, I have further simplified the numerator. We can rewrite the above statement as L is equal to limit of cube of sine of x upon x times limit of 1 upon cosine of x times 1 plus cosine of x as x approaches 0. We know cosine function is continuous at 0, so at x is equal to 0, limit of cosine of x is equal to 1. And also, we know limit of sine of x upon x is equal to 1 as x approaches 0. The verification of this limit value is shown in the video appearing in the upper right corner of this video. The link of the video is also given in the description section. Application of the above fact gives us L is equal to half. Thank you for being with me. I hope you like this video. Please click the like button and subscribe button. Do not forget to press the notification bell so that you get the notifications of my new videos. Share the video and do write in the comments. I am eager to listen to your thoughts. If you have any question related to video, if you think I should make a video on any other topics in which you are interested, please write in the comments. Thank you.